Hi, it's Vicky here, and today I will be showcasing the October card kit by Simon Says Stamp. So before I go ahead and start with my cards today, first let's take a quick look on what's inside the kit. As usual, you will find your 6x6 patterned paper, and here you can see all of the different designs and all the colors that you can find inside. Some of those patterned paper have nice golden foil details. There is also a Hello Die by Simon Says Stamp, this embroidery floss, and a clear stamp set. The designs in this clear stamp set match perfectly the pattern paper, so you can see that pattern in the hearts appears in many papers, and also there is a beautiful gold foiled pattern paper with a glass. I'm just trying to find it here. And what I really love in this card kit is that it comes with this pack of journaling cards. You can use them, of course, on your Project Life cards, but pretty much each one of those cards can make another card. You just stick it on top of another pattern paper and you have your card ready. I am going to show you a couple of ideas on how you can use those today on the video, and I will be posting another video with one more idea later this week. Of course, the kit comes with cardstock with colors that perfectly match the pattern papers, and also there is a gold ink pad in the kit that it doesn't show here. For my card today, I decided to go with these two journaling cards, the one with the butterfly and the one that looks like a tag. From this pattern paper, I will be using my stitched rectangle, and I will be cutting out a panel. So I am using my Sizzix die cutting machine to pass it through, and I will be having a panel that is slightly smaller than a standard card. I am using tape adhesive at the back of this journaling card, so I will be creating a shaker card today, just because this has already this die-cut butterfly. I just couldn't resist to make another shaker card. And as I'm doing that, just to let you know that there is a giveaway on my blog. So for a chance to win this October card kit by Simon Says Stamp, make sure to join my blog and enter your details. I'm using some foam tape at the back to go all around the butterfly to create my shaker card box. So I am going to make sure that once I add my sequence inside, nothing is going to move and fall outside of my box. I am going to add some silver sequence, and I am covering everything with a piece of paper. So here is my shaker window. I am going to use my scissors to cut out whatever sticks out from the paper that I have stuck at the back. And now I'm ready to stick this shaker element on top of my tag. I will be adding some tape runner at the back of my shaker element to stick it on top of the tag. And I want to make sure that this yay sentiment doesn't show. So I'm going to cover it up, and now I can thread some floss from the kit through that hole on the tag. I like adding embellishments like threads, ribbons and strings on my cards because they make the card more interesting looking. So it's time to stick my shaker element on top of my panel. To do so, I'm using some foam tape at the back to add even more dimension. The foam tape that I am using isn't very thick, so it doesn't add too much bulk on my cards. And I am going to stick my tag offset on my panel. So now I am going to create my standard card out of this cardstock, which is vanilla cardstock, and it was included in the kit. I am cutting it out at 4 1/4 and folding it at 5 1/2, so I have a top folding standard card. I have used some tape runner at the back, and I'm sticking it at the center of my card base. So just to do some finishing touches, first of all I need to add my sentiment. For the sentiment I am going with a phrase from this stamp set. So I am going for "You are pretty fantastic", and I am going to do some embossing. Just because all the colors and every element in this card is very pale, I decided to go with a black cardstock for the back of my sentiment, just to make sure that it really stands out. The embossing powder that I am using is Vanilla by WOW. So I am applying my embossing powder over my sentiment, which I have stamped with Versamark ink. And now I'm going to go with my heat gun and melt my powder. So once everything is ready, I am going to use my paper trimmer and cut out a very thin strip of this sentiment. I am going to use my scissors and create a fishtail at the edge of this sentiment. And then I can use my tape runner and stick it over this shaker tag. As always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below in the description area if you're watching on YouTube, or you can find the full list on my blog. And once my sentiment is there, I am going to add a couple of glue dots on my card, and this is going to secure the flaws so that it stays where I want it to be. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And don't forget to visit my blog and enter the giveaway. Here are a couple of close-up photos of the card today. For more inspiration, here are two more cards using butterflies. Click on the video that you want to see, or if you're watching from a mobile device, you can find links to those two videos just below in the description area and also on the info card that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching!